Ah, Britain, I knew I could count on you. Whether it's killer seaweed, big rubber dinosaurs, or Kojak indulging his inner dominatrix, you always know how to fulfill my cult movie needs. Today's movie is a piece of 70s British sci-fi called The Final Program, or as it's known in North America, The Last Days of Man on Earth. It's based on a series of books about secret agent Jerry Cornelius, written by sci-fi author Michael Moorcock, who also wrote lyrics for the band Hawkwind. I guess check out some of my older videos if you want to learn about them. Anyway, I haven't read any of the Jerry Cornelius books, but from what I understand, they're weird and they don't really make a whole lot of sense. So in that regard, this is actually a pretty faithful adaptation. Oh, well, this looks promising. Maybe if I keep watching, it'll turn into a Monty Python sketch. Yeah, I wish. Anyway, as stated earlier, the main character is one Jerry Cornelius, a secret agent with the looks of James Bond and the wardrobe of Austin Powers, who's in the middle of a desert attending his dad's funeral.
True liberation. You mean death?
Alright, take it easy, Jerry. Just because you look like that doesn't mean you actually are Jim Morrison. Anyway, it turns out Jerry's dad was a scientist working on a top-secret project, and one of his colleagues now wants Jerry to retrieve some microfilm from his house.
There's still some specific information which he kept in the house in England. If you could arrange, I'm quite sure it would be his wish.
Okay, wait. So, basically, Jerry's top-secret mission is to help give away some of his dad's stuff. I guess they must be saving the mission where he goes through his dad's old Playboys for the next movie.
The soul may awaken to the mission.
Jesus, back up a couple of steps, will you, crazy brows?
The Dark Age, Mr. Cornelius. The long, dark age. And it's about to end.
Oh yeah, there's also something about the world being about to end, too. Hey, as long as it turns out better than 2012, I'll be happy.
The end of the world. How long have we got?
A year or two, maybe less.
Well, according to this movie, it's in about 90 minutes. The movie informs us that in addition to being a secret agent, Jerry's also a Nobel Prize-winning physicist. And it's a good thing that it does, because we never see him doing anything even remotely sciency in the movie. Actually, now that I think about it, he doesn't really do anything that secret agent-y either. The only things he seems to be good at are eating chocolate cookies and drinking and driving. I don't know, maybe if you own both a helicopter and a plane, that was enough to qualify you as a secret agent scientist back in the 70s. Apparently getting the microfilm won't be easy, since Jerry's drug-addicted brother Frank is holed up in his dad's house and is also keeping Jerry's sister Catherine there.
Frank, what's that little something doing to her?
Well, come on, Jerry, just indulge him a little bit. You know, share a joint with him, maybe watch a little bit of his new Last Starfighter Blu-ray. I mean, that's what I do when I want to get something from my brother.
I'm afraid the old place is going up. Napalm, probably.
Or just blow him up, that'll work too, I guess. Well, Jerry doesn't have any napalm, but maybe the head of the Amish armed forces will have some for him.
Not at all, not at all. Pleasure doing business with you, sir. You miserable son of a bitch.
Oh, great. The movie's insulting me directly now.
And what about the bloody drop tanks?
Well, what about the bloody drop tanks?
Well, I need them, don't I?
I love how pissy he gets. It's like he's a 16-year-old girl that got the wrong car for her birthday.
Well, I need them, don't I?
Well, General Abe Lincoln doesn't have any napalm for you. Maybe you'll have better luck at the giant pinball arcade with people dressed up as the balls? I guess cosplay was a lot different before video games.
Hello, Shades.
Oh, come on, seriously? You're gonna try and get help from the creepy Nazi guy from Raiders of the Lost Ark? Is there anything about this guy that strikes you as even remotely trustworthy?
Still up there at number one. Two presidents and one queen. How's that for cult lass?
He's like if somebody took Benny Hill and decided to ratchet up the creepy pedophile vibe a couple more notches.
What about napalm?
Napalm.
Well, hey, napalm, napalm, tomato, tomato. As long as it burns people, it's all good.
Tomorrow. Tomorrow is Sunday. So, all the shops are shut.
Wait, if you can buy it in a store, why don't you just go there yourself and buy some?
Okay.
Hey, look, more characters. And these ones might actually be important to the story. Hopefully, maybe.
Brother,
and
I would
if
like
he doesn't come, do you propose to abandon the whole idea?
Of course not.
Abort the final program.
Title drop.
I think they all feel.
Feel away, Dr. Smiles.
Dr. Smiles? Well, I guess it could be worse. It could be Dr. Giggles. Anyway, Cruella De Vil here is Miss Brunner, and it turns out she was also involved in the secret project Jerry's dad was working on, which has to do with finding a formula for immortality and blah blah blah. The point is she's in the rest of the movie from now on.
Oh, Mr. Cornelius, your motives in helping us seem a trifle obscure.
Yeah, kinda like the script. Before he gets the microfilm, though, he needs to test out his super secret agent gadgets. Like this gun, which also doubles as a clear Game Boy Color. Hey, that's pretty neat. You know what would be even more effective, though? A regular gun!
I read your books today. I'm impressed.
I'm embarrassed.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I thought I'd destroyed every copy.
Yeah, that's what George Lucas thought about the Star Wars Holiday Special. Seriously, though, isn't all this preparation a little much for just raiding some junkie's house? I mean, how hard could it be?
Now, the lights are coming from the house. They're designed to cause pseudo-epilepsy.
Of course, sepilepsy. I should have known. Eventually, they get inside, but Jerry informs them that there's other dangers in the house. Like having to share an elevator with these people.
Well, John will have got Catherine out by now. Just leaves Frank to deal with.
Ah, well, that doesn't...
Shut up!
Oh my god, you guys are so lame. Like, gag me with a spoon. Chaw. The three stooges here end up getting separated, which leads to... this.
But a door.
What door?
Another door. There must be another door somewhere. Here, this looks like a door.
No, it's only a bloody Black Queen.
I've got it!
What?
Wait a minute. The clue is in this music. First part. Black and white. Moderato. The king is dead. Finale.
Well, if that's a door, how does it open?
Don't you see, you fool? When it's in check.
You all right?
Okay, so that happens. Whoa, so the house has a giant chessboard and a bouncy castle? Man, Jerry's dad had the weirdest man cave ever. Ever consider just getting a foosball table?
Come on, Paris! In a garb of fleet of honor, don't you know that I'm loving you?
Wait, please, to the SL.
Jerry finally finds his sister, played by... hey, Sarah Douglas. Now I get to make another Superman 2 reference.
Come to me, son of Jor-El! Kneel before Zod!
I kind of meant a Superman 2 reference with Sarah Douglas in it, but whatever, I guess I'll take it. However, Frank bursts in and ruins the family reunion.
I'm the only one who can wake her up. She is well turned on.
Throw in your needle and come out with your veins clear, Frank.
Yeah, Frank. Don't you know drugs are only cool if you take them in pill form while you're driving? Anyway, you better hurry up and get her out of there before something bad happens, Jerry.
Jerry!
That needle could work us open to your heart, Jerry.
You got something in those needles.
Yes, yes, my universal killer.
Goodbye, Sarah Douglas. Well, it was a nice cameo while it lasted, I guess.
Oh, I'm sorry the family reunion hasn't been a great success.
Hello!
Miss Brunner gets Frank to give them the microfilm, but there's one thing she didn't count on.
Oh, one thing before you open it.
Oh! Dave Chappelle, you want to give me some help with this one? Well, Frank got away, but don't worry. Maybe if we cut to another nonsensical location and add more quirky one-scene characters, nobody'll notice.
Where's someone?
Industrial waste from the Beaujolais district of France.
Perfect. Give me some. There, you sure it's from the right bank?
Jesus, sir, I don't know what side the factory's on. Boop, boop, beedoo.
Are you interested in Frank?
And the microphone.
Oh yeah, the plot. There's so much other shit going on, I forgot all about it. Well, I guess you better keep looking for Frank. Or just take some random girl to Jerry's apartment and hang out. It's not like we're in a rush or anything.
All those questions.
Yeah, didn't expect the Spanish Inquisition.
Hmm? Oh, right.
Nobody expects the Spanish Inquisition!
No one will be seated during the thrilling bathtub toothbrushing scene. On the plus side, though, I am glad the director chose to delete the scene where Jerry takes a dump in the sink. Okay, come on, movie, you're losing me here. You better do something to get my attention quick, or I'm out of here.
I've always wanted to play like that.
Thank you, movie, that'll do nicely. It's at this point that we learn Miss Brunner has the ability to absorb people that she has sex with. Why does she have this power, you may ask? Well, the answer to that is... I have no idea. They never explain it, she just sort of does it halfway through, and we're apparently supposed to just roll with it. Eventually, though, they remember this movie's supposed to have a plot and track Frank down.
So, he could know the secret of the microfilm, too.
Yeah, I guess so. Everybody does except me.
Yeah, well, you and the audience. So after the most leisurely car chase ever, they go after Frank on foot.
I'm going to set your balls to your thighs.
Huh. Who told you I had any?
Everyone's got thighs.
All right, that's kind of funny. Whoa, we killed Frank and the drum solo. Okay, so you killed Frank and got the microfilm. So, is the movie over now? What's happening?
Look, Miss Brunner, you've got the bloody microfilm. I thought by now you'd be losing interest.
I know I am.
Now, I hate long goodbyes, so piss off!
All right, see ya. who am I kidding? You all know I'm gonna finish this thing.
And I also have it on very good authority that the world is coming to an end.
Oh, right, that whole subplot. Should probably tie up that loose end. Miss Brunner takes Jerry to a secret facility, which is also apparently the place where Spielberg and Lucas shot Raiders of the Lost Ark, and shows him some stuff that I'm sure seemed futuristic in 1973.
Well, there she is.
The most complex computer in the world.
They say it has almost twice the power of a Commodore 64.
Do you know what that is?
Well, it's got to be a brainwashing machine.
Hey, I was gonna say that! Okay, the final program. You've been talking it up the whole movie. Let's see what you got.
High energy radiation, as you probably know, may give rise to profound changes in the properties of substances. And in particular, alpha particles and neutrons may cause, because of their electrical charge, severe atomic displacement. Now, I'm not speaking only of ionization.
But the damaged alloy will then exist in a state of metastable equilibrium. The whole theory of binary alloy...
But we've made progress! We've taken the irradiation out of the realm of alloys.
Okay, I'm gonna try and explain this as best I can. Basically, they want to take the brains of the best scientists in the entire world and put all their knowledge into an equation, which they'll then feed into a computer. Then they'll feed that knowledge back into a person, but since a normal human wouldn't be able to hold that much information, they want Miss Brunner to merge with some guy called Dimitri and create a new life form.
We're about to produce an all-purpose human being. An hermaphrodite, in every respect, repeating itself over and over again.
They're going to create Lady Gaga? By the way, the guy they've chosen to merge with Miss Brunner seems to be pretty chill about the whole thing. I mean, is he really okay with just being swallowed up by some woman's vagina? Unfortunately for him, Miss Brunner really wants to have hot, sweaty, merging sex with Jerry and tries to kill him. But rather than getting mad at Miss Brunner for the whole attempted murder thing, he instead gets mad at Jerry.
So it's sin, is it?
Now, Dimitri. Look now, piss off!
You son of a bitch! I'm the one who gets to fuck Miss Brunner! I guess now Jerry gets to show off some of his awesome fighting skills.
Fuck off, you Greek maniac!
Or go down like a little bitch, one or the other.
Oh no, you're still here! It's my bitch! Help! Miss Brunner! I'm losing!
Ah, you suck, Jerry Cornelius.
Well, you took your fucking time!
So with no other alternative, Miss Brunner gets ready to merge with Jerry Cornelius.
There's no man born I can't absorb. Can't you feel our bodies merging? We shall be the new Messiah.
You are wrong. We shall be the new Messiah.
I'm pretty sure that's what she said.
We shall be the new Messiah.
Yep, that's exactly what she said. Open your fucking ears, Jerry. Alright, if you're gonna do the trippy effects thing again, we might as well have some fitting music. Turns out, though, all that crazy pseudo-scientific stuff actually worked, and Jerry and Miss Brunner merge into a new being. Wait, so this is the new Messiah? What could it be? A super-intelligent hermaphrodite? A being of pure thought or energy? A caveman! The Messiah's a fucking caveman!
See you around, sweetheart.
Caveman who does Humphrey Bogart impressions. Yeah, sure, why not?
A very tasty world.
So there you have it, folks. Some movies end with the hero riding off into the sunset. This one ends with a naked transsexual caveman walking on an ocean of urine. Michael Moorcock supposedly hated this movie, and I can kind of see why. There are some funny lines and neat ideas, but the whole thing never really gels, and it's not as fun as I think the filmmakers were hoping for. Still, if you're a fan of quirky British sci-fi, this one might be worth checking out. Well, that's all for now. Until next time.